This is Swiss and Chips, your British guide to Switzerland.
Hello and welcome to Swiss and Chips. My name is Simon.
And I'm Joe.
Today we're going to talk about Swiss sayings.
Yes, exactly. Weird Swiss things that you may have heard but not quite caught. And we'll find out what they mean.
Exactly. So basically, I use them all the time, also in English. But you make usually a confused face and then we find out, probably you can't say that in English, can you?
Yeah, exactly. And then we think, aha, we've got something to add to our list.
Yeah. So, for example, slowly there is enough hay downstairs.
But actually, we don't have any hay downstairs. It's okay. Just an empty basement.
Yeah. So basically, let's dive right in and pick one after the other. So I'm tell you the Swiss saying and you can explain what they mean.
If I know.
So the first one is Göschene Airolo.
Okay. So maybe you want to explain what those words are first.
So you don't explain what they mean, do you?
I'll now, explain
Göschene
the meaning of this
and
one.
Airolo are two places in Switzerland and they are actually connected through the Gotthard Tunnel. So a very long tunnel.
Yeah. So this one I hear quite a lot and it means in one ear, out the other.
Exactly. Yes. So you can say if someone
explains something like what Göschene Airolo means and then afterwards you still can't remember, you can say in one ear and out the other and eventually you'll be able to say Göschene Airolo.
Yeah. Or maybe a parent says to the child, oh, tidy up your bedroom and tidy up and tidy up and says it again and again and again and the child is not really listening. So you say, oh, the child just made Göschene Airolo. Tunnel between the ears.
Cool.
Second one is, shall I say it?
Yes, definitely.
Du kannst nicht zu viel Zweckli haben.
Okay, so.
Maybe first in High German, du kannst nicht das. Yeah, not in High German. Das Fünfrappenstück und das Weckli haben.
Ah, yeah, you're like, what's High German for Fünfli?
Exactly.
So in English, I know this one as well. The equivalent is you can't have your cake and eat it.
Okay, yes. And what does it mean word by word in English? You can't have the 5 cent and the
little bread roll.
Yeah, at the same time.
At the
so
same
basically,
time.
You can't have the money and the thing you want. So
I got it, right. You can't have it all. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And Fifi is 5 cent in Swiss German.
See, I had always thought this was referring to a chocolate coin because of the chocolate stick thing you can put inside the bread roll.
No.
Now it's get it.
And Fifi is the 5 Swiss cent and Fünf Liber is 5 Swiss francs.
Aha, okay. Very good.
Next one. Wiener Kärte Händchen.
Okay, so some of these I know, but soon we'll get into the territory of the ones I don't know. Would you want to say that in High German?
Wie ein umgedrehter Handschuh.
So
nicht ein umgedrehter, it's an inside out.
Umgekehrt.
Yeah, kind of,
it's,
probably.
It's like a
inside
out. Now I want to say handshoe, but it's a glove turned inside out.
Yeah, exactly.
I don't really know what this means, I have to say.
Basically, you can say it if something has something or someone has completely changed the opinion or something. So, for example, someone is living extremely unhealthy and so on, and then he goes on a retreat weekend and then he came back, Wienerkehrte Händchen, you know, he came back and was like all healthy living and so on. Then you can say, oh, you have completely changed.
Yeah.
You are.
You've turned your glove inside out.
Exactly.
But can you also use it in a negative way? For example, you know, a politician might say something one day and then a month later says something the complete opposite.
Totally.
Great.
Next one is, es geht nüt, was nicht geht. Not sure if that's a saying really or if it's more a phrase, but anyway.
This is also quite hard for me to kind of process in my head and think about what it actually means.
Es gibt nichts, das es nicht gibt.
There is nothing that there isn't.
Yeah. It doesn't nothing doesn't exist, basically.
Well, that's true.
So you can, that you say usually when, for example, you see like, Or you could say it instead, you could say, I've seen it all. Now I've seen it all. Mm-hmm. So that's when you use this phrase. For example, if I'm not sure, a dog comes with a hat from Santa Claus.
Yeah, okay. And little booties. And
you are just like, es geht nicht, was nicht geht. There is like literally nothing that doesn't exist.
Is that a bit like, you know, there's nothing, nothing is sacred anymore. Is it like that?
Yeah, if I would know what that means, then probably, yes.
You know, when people like, you know, dress their dogs up in stupid jumpers, for example.
Yeah, exactly. You can, then you say, oh, there is nothing that doesn't exist.
Hmm, I wonder if we are, just two inside out gloves at this point. Kidding. Okay, we'll come back to that.
No, we don't. Didn't you understand what I mean?
I'm just wondering if my understanding is the right one when I say that nothing's sacred anymore.
Mm. But, so, I give you another example.
Yes, please.
It's quite difficult.
Yeah, exactly.
No, it's really if you see or hear something, a story, or you see something happening that you have never seen before. That is very unusual.
In a great way or in a like, oh my God, can't they leave it alone way?
In whatever way. And then you would say, oh, now I've seen it all.
Mm.
And like, yeah, there is literally nothing that doesn't exist.
Like when they bottle Swiss Mountain Air and sell it, for example. Could you say it then? Like, oh my God.
Yeah. Yeah, you could totally be in a shop and like weird stuff. You see weird stuff and see one weird thing and you just say like, oh, you know, you say it.
Yeah.
It was naked. Okay, let's better
good.
Move on.
Yeah, definitely.
I don't think we explained that very well, but yeah.
TBC.
Complaints can go to hello@swissandchips.com.
Hello@swissandchips.org. We checked that email box.
No. Or like joe@swissandchips.org. Anyway.
So.
Next one is, das macht der Braten nicht fies.
Hi, German translation, please.
Or... Das macht den Braten nicht fett.
Aha. English translation, please.
That doesn't make the...
Roasted meat?
Yeah. Larger.
Not fat.
Bigger, fatter.
Das macht der Braten unnifies. It doesn't make the roast fattier.
Yeah.
Hmm.
So you would say that we really should have thought of examples beforehand, shouldn't we?
Like that doesn't help.
Yeah, exactly. That doesn't help, or that doesn't add much.
Oh, like that's pointless.
Yeah, basically.
Why are you doing that?
Yeah, you say like maybe you try to. Oh God!
It's like when someone's digging a hole, but the earth keeps sliding back in because they're not throwing it far away enough.
No, if someone is digging a hole and then someone else comes and says, "Ooh, I have a great idea. I take this bucket to dig deeper." And then you say, well, if you take the bucket, doesn't really help much. Mach der Brat ohne Pfiss.
Okay. Yeah, got it. That doesn't help.
Yeah.
You could say your explanation doesn't make the roast.
Yeah, exactly. Probably.
Chuckle.
So then let's better move on.
Yeah, good.
Maybe someone can explain that better afterwards on our Facebook group.
Oh, yeah.
Anyway, next one is, auf alte Pfanne lernt man kochen.
I think, didn't we agree we weren't going to do this one?
Well, basically, that means with more older people,
yeah.
Experienced people, you profit from them. Why are you laughing?
I just like the way you said with more older people. It's trying to be nice. You could say with age comes experience.
Exactly, yeah, basically. Mm-hmm. It's just used, we said we won't go into this, but I think it's important to mention it because if someone uses it somewhere, then you should know the background. So if you are a teenager, you can use it in the sense of if you...
Had a sugar mummy, for example.
Yes, you learn...
stuff.
Yeah.
Okay, enough said. Care to hand you, moving on.
Der schneller ist der geschwinder.
Yes, please.
The faster is the faster.
Ah.
It means der schnellere ist der geschwindere.
Right. Yeah.
The faster is the quicker. No, first comes first. No, the yeah.
First come, first serve.
Yeah, exactly.
Aha. Uh-huh.
That was an great. Easy one.
That's good.
Next one. Es ist nur ein Essen. It's enough. Hey, downstairs. There you go.
To me, this sounds like it could have a more explicit meaning, but I guess it doesn't. Thank goodness.
What? Why?
I don't want to go into details now.
Yeah, now I want to know.
English speakers will be like, yep.
Really? Okay,
probably.
Good.
We can make anything sound disgusting.
Yeah. Good.
Tell me the real meaning, please.
The real meaning is there is enough hay downstairs.
But we don't have any hay down there. No. There's no hay.
It means basically, now it's enough. Stop it, it's enough.
Ah, right. In an argument kind of thing, yeah. Like, hey, shut up.
Yeah, now it's slow. Usually you say, now it's slowly enough, hey, downstairs. Mm. Jetzt ist langsam, jetzt ist langsam genug, hey, unten. So that means like, with a child who is playing mad or...
screaming and running around.
Exactly, and you say like 10 times, stop it. And someone you say, now slowly enough is enough.
Okay, brilliant.
Woof.
Woof.
Next. Why don't you say one?
Because that will sound ridiculous. There's enough hay on my Swiss German.
Okay. Der Gschieder geht nah und der Esel bleibt stehen. Also one that I have heard 100,000 times from my mother. By the way, she is listening, so hi, Mom.
I could always translate this, but I don't know what a Gschieder is.
The cleverer.
Goes nearby?
No. Oh, dear. The cleverer stops and, you know...
Donkey.
And the donkey stays.
Stays still.
Yeah, stands still. That means basically the clever person gives up, you know, hands over the win to the other person.
Uh-huh.
And walks away. And then the donkey looks stupid and stands still. So you would say that if two people are arguing and arguing and arguing and arguing,
mm-hmm.
and then you say, why don't you just give up and let him win?
Mm.
Because the clever person just says, you know, this is ridiculous. Yeah. I go.
Be the bigger person.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, so that's what a mother, for example, or someone else would say.
Someone with wisdom.
Two are fighting, basically.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Woof.
Yeah, so that's basically a few of that crossed my mind. And
nice.
I've asked also in the Facebook group if anyone has some sayings that they don't know or they want us to talk about.
Mm-hmm.
And there were a few. For example, Matthias Huber, he said, "Es ist Hans was heiri." Do you know what that means?
So I've heard this a few times. That's a good saying, because there are certain ones that you hear and kind of stick in your head, aren't they?
It's actually quite similar to an English saying.
Well, now you're going to have to tell me what that is.
Potato, potato.
Hans
right. was Heiri. And Hans and Heiri are two names. So it means basically same names, same.
So this is actually swings and roundabouts.
Oh, okay.
It swings and roundabouts,
oh,
you know.
Oh, no. Then not potato, potato.
Well, also potato, potato, yeah.
Okay.
But I think we say more often swings and roundabouts.
Okay.
You know, you're either going backwards, forwards, or round, around, but whatever. It's the same,
exactly.
Really.
So you just say, like, yeah.
Hans was here.
Exactly. Yep. Then.
Rowan
Downing, he said, so, but only spoken by a chatterbox.
Hmm.
Hmm. That made me think.
Hmm.
It means, I'm not sure if he means so.
Yeah.
Like, you know, like, oh, well, really?
Oh.
Because you can say so.
Oh, can you?
Yeah.
Great.
Or, you know, if you raise your voice, it's like so. That's more like...
It's like a, oh.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, is it?
Or...
I thought it was so. Like, how's it going? So.
Oh, nein, we can't say so.
Right.
How is it going? So. No, you can't say that.
Must be a Swiss German thing that Swiss Germans think they can say in English. I guess we also say it. Okay, never mind.
Yeah, so I guess he means like so.
So.
Yeah.
So.
Then Susie, she said, Dann ist mir alles ein Ding, ob ich lache oder sing. Ich habe ein Herzchen wie ein Vögel, darum liebe ich so ring.
I wasn't expecting a song.
Well, I wasn't expecting me to sing it, but now that I'm completely soaked in sweaty and hot and full of adrenaline because of all the sayings, it just came out like that.
Okay.
Yeah, so it's not a saying, this is a children's song.
And what does it mean? And where does it come from? And where can we use it?
If children
we
can learn it? Never use it, and it's a children's song.
Oh, you know. But what does it mean?
Oh, you have to ask that.
Of course.
It's really hard to explain.
It's all one thing to me, yeah, whether I laugh or I sing.
Yeah.
Have a little heart like a bird.
I have a little heart like a bird. Sing. And that's why I laugh so easily. No, basically, it's just a happy song.
Ah, okay.
It's oh, you can say it swings or roundabout. If I laugh or sing.
Yeah, true. We need to work on that a little bit, but it's 90% there.
Okay, very good. Then Alicia, she is gave a ton of examples.
She did, yeah.
And most of them are quite rude. So.
This podcast is not X-rated yet.
Yeah. But anyway, thanks a lot for all the examples. And we picked one.
Yeah, this is a good one.
Have you been bitten by a monkey?
No, not recently. But what's the Swiss German?
Yeah, bist vom Aufbissen.
Nein.
She wrote, bist eigentlich vom Aufbissen? Or we would say, you just say like, bist vom Aufbissen. Have you been bitten by a monkey? That means like, are you crazy?
Aha, that's a good one. Yeah. I could also remember that, so that's quite useful.
Yeah, have you been bitten by a monkey?
No.
So if someone says in English, have you been bitten by a monkey? Then you would say, not sure what you mean, but probably not.
Yeah, unless you have, in which case say, yes,
yeah.
Please call a doctor.
Very good. So now I can jump over my shadow and
yeah, we forgot that one.
Which means?
Don't be afraid. Go for it.
Basically, I jumped over my shadow and sang the song.
Yes, he did. Wiener Kehrte Handschuhe.
I overcame myself, basically.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, I hope this...
In Swiss German, that means über den Schatten kumpen.
Kumpen. Jump over the shadow, yeah.
Yeah. That was confusing, probably. Now everyone is confused and have learned absolutely nothing, but anyway.
No, what I would say is I recommend that you read our show notes at the same time as listening to this episode, and then you can hear and see what's actually being said, and I think that's quite useful.
Yeah, and I think I would remember like one or two, because some are quite fun to use, and people like if you use them.
People can't believe it when you use one. Yeah. Let me put it like that. Yeah. I've mastered about three, and when I say them, people are literally like, oh?
Exactly, because it's fun. Yeah.
Do that.
Because it's, you know.
And you'll be extremely proud when that day comes, and it will.
Yeah.
Give it a year or so. And then you'll roll it out and you'll be like, yes.
Yeah, so it's really, it's quite fun. So Cushion and Airolo I would recommend, because that you can use quite often.
Yeah, especially if someone's talking Swiss German, you're like, I have no idea what you're talking about.
And Es geht nüt, was nicht geht.
Yeah, there is nothing that. Take a bit of practice for me.
No, it's just like, when someone says, I have another example.
Yes.
You are out with someone somewhere and he's like, have you seen this? Then it's always the right, you know, moment to say it. Then you can say, wow, nothing exists that doesn't exist.
Yeah, like when you see a new like worm burger or something.
Yeah. Like always when someone says, wow, this... Then you go and say it. And there is a 80% chance you are correct.
Es geht nüt, was nicht geht.
Great. Es geht nüt, was nicht geht. Very good. On that note, don't forget to do the things. You know.
No, if you've got another exciting saying that you've managed to use a lot, please share it with us, because we need to learn of each other's success with these sayings. And you can put that in our Facebook group, Switzerland for English Speakers.
Yeah, come and join. And also maybe you have better explanations than I had.
That would
I tried
also be
my
nice.
Best.
That might be hard. But also, if you want to read along with the show notes to this episode to see how the words look that we've been talking about, then go to swissandchips.com and look at the latest episode, and they're in there.
And as always, thanks a lot for listening. And don't forget to leave a review or rate us on iTunes so others can find us.
That would be awesome.
And
that's it.
Bye.